We want to solve the system of equations using the substitution method, which is an algebraic method for solving a system of equations. A solution to a system of equations is an ordered pair, or an x and y value, that satisfies both of the equations. To keep things organized, let's call this equation 1, and we'll call this equation 2. Before we start to solve this, we should keep in mind that it is possible to have one unique solution, as well as no solutions or an infinite number of solutions. Now, the first step in solving a system using the substitution method is to solve one of these equations for one of the variables. Looking at the second equation, we could solve this for y if we divided both sides by 5. So if we divide the left side by 5 and the right side by 5, notice how we would now have the equation y equals 2/5 x. Well, now that we have one of the equations solved for one variable, we'll perform substitution into the first equation. If we know y is equal to 2/5 x, we can replace or substitute 2/5 x for y in the first equation. And this will give us one equation with one variable. So by performing substitution into equation 1, we would have 2x minus 5 times y, but y is equal to 2/5 x. Equals negative 24. And now we can solve for x. It might be helpful to put this 5 over 1, and notice how the 5 simplify out. 5 over 5 is equal to 1. So when we simplify this, we have 2x minus, well, this is also 2x, equals negative 24. Here we have two like terms, but 2x minus 2x is 0. So we have 0 equals negative 24. Well, this statement is false. 0 does not equal negative 24. And this is what happens when there's no solution to the system of equations. So when using an algebraic method, or in this case, the substitution method, if the variables cancel, here we had 0 equals negative 24. This indicates there's no solution. If the statement was true, we would have an infinite number of solutions. Now let's check this graphically as well. When solving a system of equations graphically, the two lines were parallel if there was no solution. So if we take a look at the graph of these two lines, they are parallel. Here's the graph of equation 1, and here's the graph of equation 2. Notice how they both have the same slope, but they do have different y-intercepts. And since there's no point of intersection, this verifies there is no solution. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.